This video will be focusing on installation of Bitcoin blockchain. Installation means basically how to download the blockchain and how to see where and how the blocks are populated, how the directory structure in a typical Bitcoin blockchain is there and how does it exist. So in this particular video, we'll be just focusing on how to download, what are the small number of steps that we have to do on a terminal, on a Linux Ubuntu operating system. So after we have downloaded the blockchain, after we have downloaded the complete blockchain, about 380-390 GBs, then we'll start exploring the blocks of how the information is stored inside these blocks. We'll connect them with the blockchain explorers, live blockchain explorers. But for now, for a short, we'll just in few steps, we'll start downloading the blockchain, and then perhaps after it gets downloaded, I'll continue in the other video. So we go to this website, bitcoin.org download, and my operating system is Linux. Okay, just for reference, this is the same operating system that I've been using in other videos. So it is, all these are the details. So I'll go for the Linux installation. So it is downloading here. Okay, it's started twice, so I'll cancel this. And the other files of interest are verify release signatures. This also we'll save. And then the other is release signing keys. This also we will save. So in all, we are likely to have three files downloaded in the download folder. So one is still being downloaded. So let's wait. So we have the files downloaded, and we'll see what all has been downloaded. So we have downloaded this Bitcoin, the tar file, and then the release signature, the signature files, and the release signatures. So we'll go to the terminal. We'll close this extra one, and we'll move here. And here now we do some steps. Now what steps right now? What I am doing? These are optional. Just to check in case you have any doubts on the downloaded file. So import, and we import it here, and then we say gpg minus list keys, and we list the keys here, and then we verify gpg. Now these are standard commands. Verify sh2.asc. So now the last step is this. I'll recall from my history. So this command sha256, this is the command which has compared the signature and the hash values. So it has found it okay. So this file what I have downloaded is absolutely fine to work ahead. So now I have checked the, verified the file, validated the file, and now I have to install. So here I'll again recall my command. So this is the command, sudo install. These are the permissions, 77 root, and this is where I intend to install this Bitcoin file. So I'll give the password here, and it takes, okay, password wrong. What happened? Oof, I think my caps lock is on. I didn't see it. Okay, I did not do the untarring. How can I forget that? So I have to tar xzf bitcoin, and this is untarred. Now I'll have this directory cd bitcoin, and now here I so now this command is executed now, and that's all. Now we had first downloaded the file, the signature file, and the signing files. We had validated what the tar file was okay or not. We checked up with the GPG protocol, and now I have installed the Bitcoin in the user local bin folder. That is, my Bitcoin will be already working. Now it is already in the mode. Now I have to give command. So there are two ways that I can start my Bitcoin with. One is the GUI, for which most of the users may be interested. so, but I am generally comfortable with the terminal part. So, but for the sake of it, what exactly it looks like? So, I am starting the GUI part. So, the first time that I execute this command bitcoin-qt, what happens is this window comes up and it asks me if I would like to install in the default directory. So I take all the defaults and I go ahead. Now as I go ahead, there will be information regarding the time that it is likely to take. So last block time. So last block time means the first block which was generated, the Genesis block basically. It was generated on 3rd January. So this block has started downloading, and in few minutes this window will give me approximate idea of how much time with my current net speed it is going to take to download the complete blockchain. So while it syncs and while it checks up, so currently you see syncing headers etc. So 12 years 36 weeks behind. So 12 years 36 weeks means from today's date, that is I think 12th September 2021, and I reverse to 12 years and 36 weeks, so that I'll reach 3rd January around 2009. So this has already started. Now we'll just see how is it affecting the directory. So we'll go, so there is ls-a, so this is one directory. There will be by the name of Bitcoin, cd Bitcoin. So this is already started populating cd Bitcoin. And here I have these files which are still being populated, but the thing that we'll be interested in is cd blocks. Now there will be one most likely that will be downloaded. So blk, this is the first block, not exactly the block, but the first blk file in which the first few blocks were indexed inside. So we'll see how does it look like and how does it store the data inside all these files etc. in a later video. But for now, the blockchain has started downloading, and these are the typical folders that we see. So cd, I'll just show you again. So these are the typical folders, and it is likely to take few days on my speed that I have, about 3 weeks. So I think overnight it will be, by morning I'll be okay with it. So for now the GUI part is over. So GUI part is okay. We can do few settings there, options and start Bitcoin Core on system login. So instead of always doing this command /user/bin/local and starting the GUI, so I have this option to start Bitcoin. So automatically if I save this, so it gets stored in the configuration file, and whenever I start the system next, so it automatically starts the Bitcoin blockchain downloading. So now here it is. So the other way is I have a terminal way also, the CLI way. So I'll cancel this. The moment I cancel this, that window is closed, the GUI part is closed, and now I come back to the terminal. So again, in case I have this non-GUI interest, so for that the command is Bitcoin daemon. That's it. So Bitcoin Core starting. So while the blocks were started to download with the GUI part, now that I have cancelled the GUI part, now I am downloading the same with the terminal command. So bitcoin-daemon, and this has started. So this is doing the same thing which I was seeing in the GUI part, but in a terminal way. So for now, let it continue downloading. So here we are after a few days, wherein I have checked up that the complete Bitcoin blockchain has downloaded. What does it mean when I say that Bitcoin blockchain has downloaded, and what directory structure does it mean to? So we'll just see all that. So here we are. We'll go to the directory. So this was the directory, and few minutes in the initial video that we had seen the directory cd blocks, and then there were two files. Now let's see how many are there. So there are a whole lot of files, and we can just count them. So there are about 5500 files, and this means that right from 03rd January 2009, the complete blockchain, the complete number of blocks which were populated over this last decade, they have downloaded. Now how do we know? Now there are few peculiar commands that we can get the information from. Now I'll use the CLI way, get blockchain info. Now these are terminal commands which gives us a lot of information. So Bitcoin CLI get blockchain info, what will it give? It will give again a whole lot of info, and we'll just see it means. So we see there are 70383 703383 blocks, number of headers, this is the best block hash, and so much of information is there. Now, how do I know that this is the latest block which has been mined and or this is updated? So header means what is shown here is that the complete blocks which have been populated till date, and blocks, it means the complete number of blocks which are updated in my machine here. So here we see both the values are matching. That means the blockchain is updated, and this we can also cross check from by going to any blockchain explorer. So let's go to btc.com and we are here. So we'll go to explorer Bitcoin and we'll see what is the latest block. So 703383. Now this is a this information that we are seeing on the screen, this is from a open blockchain Bitcoin explorer, and these are the informations which are being seen. Height 70383, so here in case we compare 703383, this is the same, and a whole lot of information that we had earlier also checked up in the explorer, the while checking the difficulty, targets, etc., Merkle root, etc. So all this information while we were fetching that information from the explorer that time, here I'll introduce you to few commands which will give the information from the from your machine, from the machine, from the blockchain that we have downloaded recently. So we'll use, like, we have already checked up get blockchain.info. Now get connection count, that means how many connections are we connected to? 10. So that is the maximum that a machine can connect to anytime. It has never gone beyond 10. So the other is get mining info. Now there are about 40 plus commands wherein in this video I'll be showing you about maybe about 10-11 commands. So here is the mining information. Mining information means what is the difficulty and what is the network hashes per second, what is the current rate which is being used. Then we have got get net totals. Now this is what number of bytes I have received, and what these are various parameters that we'll go into details what it actually means in a few videos ahead that I intend to populate. Then we have got list transaction. Now list transactions is a command, but I am likely to get a zero here because I have not done any transaction, so it is a zero. Otherwise the list of transactions will be populated here. Now this we have got this Bitcoin CLI get block hash. Now get block hash means in case I give a block here, suppose 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so I'll get the hash here. So this is the hash. Now we can just check it from the explorer. Now in case I add here 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so it'll take some time, and here I'll get it. I think I've got it. Okay, I'll go to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 in Bitcoin, and I am likely to get the same hash what I see here on the terminal. So I have got here is F052D, and by the time it F052D. So this is you can connect what we are seeing live from a blockchain explorer which is available on the web, and then we have got this CLI way that we have checked up it from here. So then there are other commands. We can go for any other, say 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, we can go. So it'll be E8F. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, we'll again go the, so FEE8F and FEE8F. So these both are the same. So the blockchain, this explorer, this is also fetching data from some blockchain which it has its from its own node, and here I am fetching these data from the blockchain that I have downloaded from my node. So then there are few other interesting commands. Okay, Bitcoin get difficulty. So that gives the difficulty level 1899. This we have calculated earlier in case you remember. Then we have got get peer info. This is interesting. This will give us some IP addresses. Okay, I'll just start from the beginning. Get peer info. So we had seen that while we use this command get connection count. So we had seen then the connection counts were 10. So now what are those 10 connections that we are connected to? So this gives you a basic overview of those addresses. What are the IP addresses? Again, this gives us a whole lot of information, and in case I start going into each and everything, so that'll take a separate video in itself, and that I intend to do later. But for now, you can just see at a later time while we scroll down, we'll see all these IP addresses also. So with the port numbers, etc. Now these IP addresses, what you are seeing, these are not that are connected in terms of transactions. These are the peers that I am connected to. It is not necessary that in case I do a transactions, they will be able to know my IP address. This is just a mempool kind of a thing. These are randomly fetched IP addresses, 10 in numbers, with the gossip protocol. So now we'll go check another. We'll see get peer info. I think I have done. Okay, peer info I have done. Then I'll say get raw mempool. Now mempool, in case you can connect with an earlier video, we had discussed about what raw mempool is. So this is giving out a number of hashes here. So these are all the unconfirmed transactions which are still there in the mempool. So, and then we can again, okay, yeah, there's one, this block count and 703384. Now this is the most updated, the most recent block which has been populated, and this is available with this command Bitcoin CLI get count. Now again, another interesting command to know about the directory structure is tree minus d Bitcoin. So this will give us the directory structure which has populated. Okay, what have I done? Sorry. Yeah. So this is the directories which have been populated. So we have seen CD blocks. It shows us a number of blocks inside, and chain testnet is one. This will not be populated in case you have downloaded and in comparing with this video, because this testnet is a separate blockchain, testnet test blockchain, which I have downloaded peculiarly for my machine, and that's a separate thing in itself. Now while here what we are seeing and what data we are fetching is from the mainnet, the main blockchain, but here testnet is another blockchain which you can download just for testing. So you can populate, you can do transactions, and you can see your transactions getting populated in this blockchain. So this is a basically a kind of a test bench. So what is the approximately size? DU minus H. So this will give the complete size of Bitcoin directory which has populated, and this is about 459 GB, while I said about 390 GB is the blockchain size. So this consists of the testnet, etc., all these extra directories also that which are populated. So we'll go to the blocks directory and we'll run this command same. So here it'll be about 390 GB. So 391 GB is the current blockchain Bitcoin website. Now, now we'll just open one block. Now these are BLK00. This was the first block which started downloading while we started this video. And since then, all these blocks have downloaded. And the number of files are, we checked up about, ls minus lrthwc minus l, so 5500 are the number of files. Okay, now another thing is I'll just show you what exactly information is stored inside. So I'll just open this blk00 file, the first block which was downloaded. Now it completely looks, I'm sorry for the sound, completely looks a junk of hexadecimal, but it gives us a lot of information. Now how to read this and how to translate all these hexadecimals into useful information, I'll do it in a separate video. But this is all what the Bitcoin blockchain downloads in your machine whenever you download, and this is how the information looks like. So this is all hexadecimal, and in case I can show you, so this one I was talking about. So while the first block which was mined on 3rd January, so this is the information that Satoshi Nakamoto had given up. Now this I had discussed in one of my earlier videos also, when 03rd January 2009, Chancellor on the brink of second bailout. Now this was the heading of that thing of the newspaper, of the Times newspaper which was published. So this was the only hint and only connect that the financial debacle in July 2008 which had happened globally. So it had got something to do with it. That's the only connect that we can see, or we could know about this. So this video I'll end up here. In the next video, in the playlist that I intend to populate later, I'll open one of these blocks and try to translate all these hexadecimal information into useful information. So for now, we'll just revise what we did in this video. We started with a new virtual machine on Ubuntu. We downloaded the Bitcoin core software and we checked up by doing two methods of how to download the blockchain Bitcoin. We did the GUI attempt and we did the CLI attempt. So while we started, we had seen the first directory population of blk0000.dat file, which was just populated immediately when we had started downloading the blockchain. And thereafter, after about few days, I continued again this video. While I was able to completely download the blockchain, and today it stands at 391 GB, and we have basically compared also of how the blockchain which is downloaded on my machine, it is absolutely updated, and it is matching with the any Bitcoin Explorer that we had seen. So henceforth, now this video, as I said, is only peculiar to downloading of Bitcoin blockchain and just seeing directory structures, what are affected and how are the files populated, what are the number of files, what is the approximate size of Bitcoin, etc. blockchain. And now later on, what we will do is we'll just open up any block and we'll try to read information about it. So thank you so much, and I hope you liked it. And in case you really liked it, I'm sure you will like and subscribe it. Thank you so much.